going to keep this dog?
Yes, great dog, I reckon.
That's a beauty. So, kiddies, what should we do today?
We'll have to get back.
Yeah, I know. We'd love to stay and play, but you know, I got to work.
Oh, such a beautiful day.
Well, I should be taking a happy pills or something.
Yes, it's all cowboys and Indians to her.
Okay, so we're on the run, but they haven't found us yet, and there's a good chance they won't.
Not for a couple of days, if we're lucky.
Let's face it. We have all been on the run from something at some stage in our lives. I mean, God knows I have been avoiding the tax man for years. Valentine's just come out of hiding.
Don't kid yourself.
Don't tell me that you're not terrified of love catching up with you.
Oh, I'm rather crumbling jacket or what?
Shade down. Look, just because we have a couple of cops chasing us, I don't really see why that should spoil our day.
No.
What are you cooking?
Beans again.
Oh, yuck.
Nice, huh? You want some? Want to try some? They're beautiful. Come on. A bit of chili in there. That's good.
Oh, yum.
Gets it going, doesn't it?
The routine. From the routine.
The routine.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Wayne, okay. Newton, move over. Watch this. Ready?
Shoom, bugger, lugger, lugger. Shoom, bugger, lugger, lugger. Shoom, bugger, lugger, lugger. Boom. Vegas, here we come.
Yeah.
Our police reporter tells us that Stanley Kovac and Sheridan Sturgis are still on the loose.
Yay, Wheels, I'm on your side, dude.
Members of the public are warned that Kovac and Sturgis are armed and dangerous and should not be approached.
Hey, they can't talk like that about them.
Well, the police don't know them like we do, Claire.
They dug themselves in a pretty deep hole by the sounds of things, eh, Max?
It's not fair.
What am I going to do about Martha's job?
Pick up a council.
That's a bit drastic.
Well, how else do you get a local member to see sense?
Want some more toast over here, please, Ernie?
What's the rush?
Things are happening down the station, mate. Mr. Patcher.
What can I do for you?
I need a room.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Max.
You know him?
Yeah.
Well, roommate's free. It's at the back, nice and quiet.
Yeah, can I have a look?
Hang on, I'll get your key.
Moving out of home, mate.
Yep, I'm a big boy now, Max.
Have a chair.
You little man. Rotten things must have brains. These mice. They've done it again.
Done what?
Taken the bait, sprung the trap, and they've gotten Queen away.
Really?
Yeah, really. Must be all this hanging around your lecture. Opera bus. Makes our mice smarter than the average, huh?
Yeah, must be.
You remember when breakfasts around here were nice and quiet?
Yeah, the house music played at 10 decibels only. You are worse than usual this morning, Jamie.
Yeah, and you know why that is. Our resident legal got proposed to last night.
Yeah, have you heard from Penny this morning?
It must be some sort of bad joke. It has to be. What could be bad about marrying a chick like that?
Look, I don't flatter myself for one moment to think that Penny seriously wants to marry me.
Why would she make a joke like that?
She wouldn't. Hey, take it from me, Jamie. If Penny O'Brien says she wants to marry you, you don't get much choice in the matter.
Meaning?
Penny gets what Penny wants. Thanks.
And what I'm telling you is that it is not a police matter. Goodbye.
Hey, Sarge. You know Sam's moving out of home today?
I've got better things to do around here than sit around gossiping, Max.
Sarge, is there something I should know about?
You know, I'm starting to think that neither of us is supposed to know anything around here, Max. The whole point of the exercise is to keep you and me, especially me, well and truly in the dark.
You mean Ed?
Yes, Max, I'm talking about Ed Farrell.
Sarge, with a bit of luck, Valentine will be able to talk Wheels and Sheridan into surrendering.
No, Valentine won't tell us where they are. There's Ed, just itching to get in there with guns blazing. Whichever way it goes, it makes us West Side cops look like idiots. Not a good feeling, is it, Max?
Well, whatever you do, mate, just don't get involved. Okay?
What, let you two go?
Yeah, let's go. We'll be fine, mate.
Okay, okay. Fine.
Thanks.
Not much, but it's
home. You guys could turn that into some sort of venue or something.
Oh.
Yeah. You're going, Jojo.
Oh, yeah, right, boss.
So, do you want me to sell the bike and get the cash, do you?
Nah, you ride it, mate. Just don't bend it, that's all.
Well, see you.
Oh, yeah.
See ya.
Look after yourself, mate.
You too.
You too, eh?
Yeah.
Take care.
Look after the tripod.
Oh, we will.
Tripod?
Adios, guys.
Bye.
You know, it doesn't seem right leaving them.
No.
Do you think they'll be okay?
Sure. Gonna believe that.
That's the 15th call I've made this morning.
Welcome to the wonderful world of doing business with a government department.
You'd think that somebody would be prepared to listen to reason.
Won't they give Martha a job back?
No, it's not that they won't give it back.
They want me to work shorter hours.
But wouldn't that make you happy?
No.
Martha needs more hours to do a job, not less.
Maybe I should send them a bill for all the 80 and 90 hour weeks I've put in for them over the years.
You can imagine the response. You'd be filed under T for troublemaker.
If I haven't been already.
If I were you, I would stick to selling Lippy.
Why, Claire?
Well, you do a great job looking after sick people.
But they're not all sick.
But you have to give them baths.
Yes, and I do their shopping for them and I write their letters for them.
Well, most people don't realise how much Martha's patients depend on her. To some of them, she's more important than their own families.
You know, Claire's onto something here. Do you think there's some way of showing the top brass what really happens? I mean, letting them hear it from my patients themselves, how I actually help them with their lives.
Yes.
Huh, sure. All we've got to do is get them on the phone.
Well, I've made 15 calls this morning. I can make 15 more. 50 if I have to. Okay.
What do you mean with appearance? Uh-huh. I dress sharp. The hair's always slick. I never go out without a shave.
What a man.
But this, look at this.
What?
Grass seeds in his hair. And the clothes look like they come from St. Vinny's and they have never, ever seen an iron.
I iron.
So, he gets the hottest lady in town and what do I get? Nothing.
Well, maybe you're just a late developer, CJ. I'll get it.
Yeah, good idea.
Mm. Look what you've got on, mate. You
hey, hello.
Hey. These are the threads of the future.
Yeah, just a moment.
This?
I'll see if he's free.
What do you think?
Jamie. It's Mr. Hughes' secretary.
What does she want? It's about the job. What else?
Hello, yes, James Newman speaking. Yes, Yes, of course, I did. Yes.
Well?
Tell us.
Come on.
He wants to have lunch with me today.
My man, this is great news.
He wants to have lunch with me and my wife at our place.
This is not good news.
Oh. Oh, I've been waiting for you. Uh-huh. Don't be shy. What do you got for me?
Nothing.
How hard did you look for them?
I did my best.
Ed Farrell is not going to accept this, you know, Valentine.
I don't give a damn what Ed Farrell
You're not doing them any favours by concealing them.
Me and Wheels go back a long way. If he had wanted me to find him, I would have found him.
Yeah, that's what I figured. And why do I get the feeling that you're not being straight with me?
Don't know. Mystery to me.
West Side Police, George Sullivan. Yep. Right. Yeah, I'll tell him. Sam.
Sergeant.
Just had a call from Newbridge.
Yeah, what's going on?
The guy that you shot in the holdup. He died this morning.
Sure.
Sorry, son.
Penny, Jamie wants to ask you a favour, Jamie.
It's fantastic, Charlie.
What are friends for?
It's a fairly large favour, Penny.
Try me.
Go on, try it.
You know how you spoke to Wilcox Gardner and Hughes yesterday?
I remember.
Mr. Hughes, the senior partner, he wants to have lunch with me.
Oh, great.
And my wife. Before he decides whether or not I'm suitable for the job.
That's ridiculous.
Have you changed your mind?
I knew what I said to you.
Why did you want to meet your wife? She's not the one applying for the job.
Something to do with company policy.
I give up. The whole world's gone to hell. When do I have to meet him?
Today? At lunchtime?
You know, Sarge, I thought someone like Sam would have taken a shooting like that in his stride.
Yes, well, his old man would have. You know, the more I see of Sam, the more I realize how totally different he is from his father.
He's still a good cop, though.
Probably a better cop than Ed could ever have been.
Really?
It's a machine, Max. We don't need that in the force.
I like machines. I don't get emotional. Anyway, where's Sam?
He went for a walk a while ago.
I think he's at the pub, Mr. Farrell.
What's he doing at the pub?
He's taking a room there. I think he said something about wanting to move some of his stuff in this afternoon.
The guy that Sam shot in the holdup, he died this morning. The kid's pretty cut up about it.
Cut up about some punk getting what he asked for?
Yes. I told him to take some time out.
What is this place, a cop shop or a kindergarten?
Look, I'm his senior officer. I did what I thought was best.
Sam's an adult, not some wet behind the ears kid.
Have you got any business with us?
Well, Valentine, no. Has he reported back yet?
Yep, half an hour ago.
Well?
He said he couldn't find either Wheels or Sheridan.
Do you believe him?
No, but I don't think there's much we can do about it.
Then I think it's about time I gave Mr. Valentine a little visit.
Look all you want, but don't expect her to give you a second look.
She's something else.
And I ain't?
You ain't.
Hi, CJ's in there.
Hello. I was told that Sam Farrell lives here.
Yeah, I'll take you to him. Hey, what are you, his sister, cousin?
Didn't you just tell me where he is?
Upstairs, third room on the left.
Okay, thank you.
Open. Hi.
Hi. What are you doing here, Sam?
Unpacking and then I'll have to get back to work. I haven't really got time to talk right now.
Okay, just wait a minute. One second. We're engaged to be married. Is that correct? And, people who are engaged to be married find the time to talk to each other. Are you going to tell me what's going on?
I don't know what's going on, Amy.
Sam.
The guy shot in the armed holdup is dead, Amy.
You did what you were trained to do.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. It isn't really helping. I wish you hadn't gone to so much trouble, you know. You should have got some takeaway.
Takeaway?
Well, he wouldn't have known.
But I would have. I would have felt like a failure as a wife.
Ah.
I don't know how to cook roast beef.
Ah, but I do. You can make the soup.
Yeah, easy. I'll do something for dessert too, huh? Ice cream?
The man can cook. You know, Jamie, you'd be a pretty good catch. What else is there I should know about you?
Not much, really.
Oh, Jamie, we've been married for 5 years. The boss is coming over for lunch. He might expect me to know a few of your little quirks.
I don't have any quirks.
Habits, hobbies.
Well, yes, good thinking. I love opera.
Favourite opera?
Rigoletto.
Rigoletto?
How about Magic Flute? Can you remember that?
The Magic Flute. So, when you're not listening to the Magic Flute or down the beach with your daughter and wife, what else do you do?
Build ships in bottles.
What?
I build ships in bottles, you know, like Spanish galleons, clippers, that sort of thing. I put them in bottles.
Why?
Why? Well, I find building ships in bottles particularly challenging. I mean, it's real finicky. When it comes off, it's great.
Good. Mr. Hughes will find that a favourable character trait. You love attention to detail.
Yeah, I do. Thanks, wifey.
That's okay, hubby.
So they lock Sheridan Sturgis away for shooting Steve Richardson. And I shoot a guy and I'm a hero.
Sam, he could have killed somebody.
Yeah, he might not have. Guess it's a bit late to find out now. Dad.
Sam.
What are you doing here?
How are you, Mr. Farrell?
Look, Sam and I have important things to discuss.
You're asking me to leave?
Listen, I'll call you. We'll have some dinner tonight, okay? Bye.
Sorry. I can see you've moved in. Why? Well, I can understand you wanting to be on your own for a while.
Can you? All right. Of course. Ed Farrell killed people too, didn't he?
A couple. But at least they had the capacity to shoot back.
What?
The bloke you shot wasn't armed.
What are you saying? He had a gun at the girl's head.
He had a water pistol at the girl's head.
What?
But Harry Haddock fixed it for you. He planted a real gun. He's a good man, Harry.
I don't believe you. I saw the gun.
Take it easy. No one else is going to spread it around. Harry knows a bit better than that. You know what would happen if the press got hold of this?
I'd be out of the force, and I'd probably be up on charges.
Not probably about it. Oh, Sam. Sam, it could have been a real gun. You thought it was, didn't you? You're a cop. These things happen.
I shot an unarmed man.
Things happen, and things can be fixed. That's the upside of being Ed Farrell's son. Don't worry about it. Look, I need police backup on the little job I'm doing.
Max is on duty, Dad.
No. I want someone I know I can trust. And if you can't trust your own family, who can you trust?
What are you eating? It looks disgusting.
I'm not sure what it is. I can eat those oysters, but I thought I'd leave them to you.
Oh, I could go a dozen natural oysters right now. You know, we have to get some food.
Let's get some baked beans and some tinned stew, I reckon.
Yeah, that sounds a bit Ned Kelly for me.
And some dog food, not for me, for the dog.
What about a small jar of caviar and some smoked salmon?
Oh, yeah, that'd be really nice. I think we've only got about $5. That's it.
Now, didn't your mummy ever teach you how to use a credit card?
No, I missed out on that one. Mm-hmm. I don't think they take them down the local store anyway.
No, I'll get a cash advance.
Oh, yeah? Really?
Hmm.
We'll be the first outlaws to buy baked beans on an Amex.
Gold Amex. Oh, champagne. I think we need champagne, too.
Champagne? Okay. That's disgusting. Champagne? Guns and champagne. Sounds good, doesn't it?
Works for me.
Works for you?
Please, come in.
Thought maybe you hadn't heard us over the noise.
Hey, boy.
Didn't you know it was rude to go on playing when someone wants to talk to you?
You should have said. I just thought you wanted to come around and kick in my doors.
Sergeant Sullivan tells me you went looking for Kovac and Sturgis. You found them, didn't you?
Is that what the Sarge said?
I don't reckon he believes you when you say you didn't. I certainly don't.
Well, I guess you guys are trained not to believe people, hey?
We're trying to spot liars. It's all right. It's all right. Hey, here you are. Look at that baby. Oh, careful, careful. Look. These things are pretty valuable, aren't they?
Does Charlie have any other clothes?
What's wrong with this?
Why don't you go and wash your face, sweetheart, and find a pretty dress to put on.
A pretty dress?
Mm-hmm. The blue and pink one with the lace on it.
I'm sorry to be so stuffy.
Yeah, well, you know your boss. Now, what can I tell you about me? Youngest child of older parents who were overly protective. Rebelled at 18 and ran off with an absolute wanderer. Had Charlie, married and divorced.
I don't think we can use any of that over lunch.
I guess not.
Well, what we need to do is make up some sort of history.
Like you and me type history?
Yeah, you know, how long we've known each other. Where did we meet?
In Paris in the rain.
You said you'd help me, Penny.
I wanted to be an actress before I became a fashion designer.
Hey.
It'll be all right on the night.
Get out of it, will you? Don't... Penny.
Nothing you can tell us, Valentine? Nothing you know? No clues?
We need to find them. Sergeant Sullivan's explained to you how important
it is. Dr. Rock. Funny how you got so much to say on the radio. Now you just can't find your voice. What do you reckon, Mr. Valentine?
I reckon nothing, Mr. Ed.
Funny man, are you? Oh, you'd love to have a go at me, wouldn't you? Well, I'll mince you up for nothing, Sally.
You'll never know, old man.
You old man.
That's enough!
I'll give you a...
If you touch this man again, I'm going to have to charge you with assault.
I haven't finished with you.
Thanks for your cooperation, Mr. Valentine.
Whoa.
That's it. Wish me luck, Amadeus.
Movie.
Well, you look...
I hate this dress.
You only have to wear it for a couple of hours, Charlie. Now, what did I tell you?
Mum says I have to pretend you're my dad.
Well, you'd be doing me a huge favour.
Now, the nice man's name is Mr. Hughes. Smile, Jamie. We have a happy, happy marriage and the roses bloom sweetly in our garden of love.
What a charming child.
That's Charlie and I'm Penny. How do you do? Oh, they're beautiful.
Glad you could make it. I'll get you a drink, wine, whiskey.
Orange juice if you have it.
Orange juice?
I'll get it, darling.
Well, well, what a refreshing change. A young man like you with a lovely wife and child. Is that a roast in the oven?
Are these the people that Martha usually looks after?
Yeah, some of them. Ellie asked them to come in. So I hope you're not sick, because we haven't got time for sick people.
Well, I still...
Oh, sorry.
Thanks for coming. And for being so patient.
Oh, never mind. Have you heard any news?
Well, I couldn't get anywhere with the minister himself, but I managed to get onto one of his underlings, Mr. Kennedy.
Is he coming?
In about an hour. So
So, let's sort out what we want to tell him. Now, what do we need? Money and lollipops.
Be quick.
Hey. You wait here.
Now, I know carving's a man's job, Mr. Hughes, but we like to pay lip service to women's liberation here. Don't we, darling? Darling?
Yes, I'll do my best.
Why don't we excuse Charlie from the table, Jamie?
Sure. Why don't you go off and play with your dolls, sweetheart?
Dolls? What was that opera we were listening to last night on the radio, Jamie? Rigatini, wasn't it?
That's Rigoletto, sweetheart.
Oh, how silly of me. Mm. Do you like opera, Mr. Hughes?
Well, I prefer the classics to the strange noises they call music these days.
Pop and rock and roll and what have you. Yes, so do we. Why don't you tell Mr. Hughes about your other hobbies, Cherub? Collecting empty bottles.
Empty bottles? Bottles of spirit?
No, I build ships in bottles.
Tiny little ships with tiny little sails. My Jamie's a very clever boy, Mr. Hughes.
Young love, it makes the world go round.
Yes, that's what we think, isn't it, darling?
Dad put the money into my account on Friday. I know he did. He wouldn't lie. Look, here's his deposit slip.
Look, that doesn't alter what our records show.
Oh, please. Look, she has a deposit slip. Now, obviously, you have made a mistake. Can we move this along, please?
All I can suggest is you go see your father's bank.
I would like to make a withdrawal.
Okay, I'm sorry. No, look, you take the lock, but please don't shoot.
What are you doing? Give him the money back.
No, he wants us to have it.
It's not mine.
It's not his. He wants us to have it.
Here, take the money.
Daryl. Hmm? No, where's the door? Where's Daryl? Daryl!
There's Daryl. Come on, let's go. Come on, Daryl. Good Daryl. Good Sheridan. Good
council people seem to think that Martha's only there to mollycoddle us.
Not so, sir.
Martha here helps us to get out and meet the people, keep our self-respect. It's a damn crime what you've done to this girl.
Yeah. Yeah. That's right.
Well, as you've heard from these good people, Mr. Kennedy, there's a lot more to Martha's job than just sitting and chatting and applying the odd sticking plaster. She's as much a social worker as a nurse.
The council is distressed about the cutbacks.
Not nearly as distressed as we are, Mr. Kennedy.
But it's not as if Martha O'Dare's position was completely dismantled.
It may as well have been. How else can I give these people the individual attention they need?
Cutbacks are made only out of dire necessity.
The dire necessity is here, Mr. Kennedy.
Look, I'm sorry. We'd restore your hours if that were possible. Now, I really must be going.
Martha? Oh, Martha, there you are, love. I'm just off to me first game of bowls.
Well, he was a dead loss.
Where are your glasses, Mrs. Smithies? You tell me and we'll both know. I've looked high and low. Had an awful time getting ready without them. So I see. Come on. Let's get you straightened up. Through here.
Sarge, doesn't Ballantyne realise how dangerous it is out there for them?
Oh, he understands, all right. But we're cops, and in his eyes, the bad guys.
Any news?
Nothing.
Well, I've got some. My own son just threatened to arrest me.
Wasn't quite like that.
No? Then how about you tell your fellow officers how it was? Tell them how I was in the middle of questioning a punk I suspected of being in collusion with an escapee when you tried to stop it.
What exactly do you mean by questioning?
Good old-fashioned interrogation, George.
You're not in a position to employ so-called good old-fashioned interrogation techniques, Dad.
Sounds like you're skating pretty close to the edge, Ed.
I'm trying to do what I've been sent to do. And all you blokes keep doing is trying to make things difficult for me.
Mr. Farrell, you don't seem to realize that Wheels and Sheridan are... we're a part of this community.
They set themselves apart from your precious little community the minute he busted her out of jail. Westside Farrell speaking. Uh-huh. Is that a matter of... is that a fact? Yeah. Well, how long ago? God, thank you. So, you don't think Kovac and Sturgis pose a threat, do you?
What do you got?
An armed robbery up north. Suspects answering to the description of Kovac and Sturgis. Farrell speaking.
Yep.
Look, we've got a lead. Get yourselves over here straight away. On the double.
Bit more colour. There. Great. Mm. Ellie, you got a mirror? Yeah. How's that?
Oh, you're a miracle, Martha.
Well,
I don't know what we'd do without you.
Look at you.
Not bad, eh? I'll show those old bowling fuddy-duddies a thing or two.
You're not kidding. Ready for that lift yet?
Ready and raring to go. Oh. Thanks, Charles. I could have made a real galah of myself down there.
Bye, Mrs. Smithers. Child? Most of them think I'm still in my 20s.
That alone is reason enough for staying in the job.
Oh, I do love it. I mean, I know it's not a picnic at times, but it really is rewarding.
What are you going to do?
I'll apply for reinstatement, accept their 25 hours, and fight to make sure there aren't any further cutbacks.
You're a good woman, Martha, dear.
Child, Dr. Fielding. A mere child.
Thank you. No. Excellent coffee and an excellent meal planning. Oh,
thank you. I enjoy cooking, Mr. Hughes, and cleaning and sewing. I guess I'm just an old-fashioned type of girl.
You're a lucky man, James.
Yes, well, I tell myself that at least three times a day, Mr. Hughes.
I suppose my wanting to meet your wife before making a decision might seem rather odd, James.
Not odd at all. Not quite orthodox, perhaps.
Well, I pride myself as not being quite orthodox. No great follower of fads. And I still believe, James, that the family is the linchpin of society.
Oh, absolutely, so do we.
I can see that. And you'd be well suited to Wilcox, Gardner and Hughes. They're all happily married men.
No women?
Well, we tried a few, but they didn't fit in. We're a close-knit group. We socialize with each other regularly.
Really?
Yes. Oh, picnics, barbecues. What would you say to that, Penny?
There's nothing my Janie likes more than a good sausage sizzle.
It's a pleasant sort of lifestyle. The two single men we employed, well, really didn't fit in. They lack stability. Mm-hmm. They're always off on another tack. It takes a woman to hold a man down.
The company sounds quite innovative and dynamic.
Well, I must go.
Oh, what a shame.
It's been a pleasure having you, Mr. Hughes.
I hope you will allow my wife, Barbara, and me to return your hospitality.
A lunch at your place?
Oh, dinner, I insist.
Might be a bit difficult. Babysitters
Plenty of time to work that out. And bring Charlie.
Barb adores kitties. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Bye, James.
Mr. Hughes, I'll see you out.
Au revoir.
I'd put my money on you having that job.
What have we let ourselves in for?
We'll take two vehicles, so we can cover a bit of territory without making ourselves too obvious.
I'm afraid that's not possible, Ed.
Why not?
Are they police vehicles you're thinking of using?
No, so it's got nothing to do with you. Now, this couple is armed and dangerous. Now, I don't want any of you to put your lives at risk by attempting to bring them in unharmed. And if there's any chance of anyone getting hurt, just shoot first.
Hang on here, just hang on here a minute. Now, I don't give a damn what authority you think you're acting under. There's no way this is anything but a vigilante group.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more. That's why we need at least one police officer to be present. Wait for me in the vehicles. Now, you've got a police station to run, so I want to take First Class Constable Farrell. Sam? And you're not going to give me any trouble, are you, George? You're welcome to discuss this with Newbridge.
Yeah, well, we all know the answer there, don't we? I want you to report back to me, Constable.
Yes, sir.
Let's go.
Sarge, you can't let them do this.
Shut up, Max. I've just about had enough of people telling me what I can and what I can't do.
How do we know she's the kind of dog Ma wants?
Well, got four legs, hasn't it? Not three.
Oh. Yep. All there.
Oh, hang about, Pete. I make it five.
Cerise! Oh, you moron. Look, you was counting his tail.
That's a relief.
Cops. Just at cool.
G'day, boys.
We paid for it.
Good money.
We got him all legal just around the corner. We can show you the receipt.
So you live around here, do you?
What's it to you if we do?
Might be able to help me out.
We ain't done nothing wrong.
Glad to hear it. I need to find these two in a hurry. Seen them around by any chance?
My whole life is falling apart.
Dishes still need to be done, Jamie.
We'd be better off if we never played this crazy charade.
I think I'd come to dinner with you.
Well, it's not just dinner. Let's just assume I've got the job.
I think that's a pretty safe assumption to make.
Ah. And then we have all these happy family gatherings two or three times a month.
That's going to be fun, isn't it?
Yes, horrible. What's going to be worse is my trying to explain where my adoring wife is at all these gatherings.
Oh, where does he get off trying to interfere in his employees' private lives?
I really want this job, Penny.
Why?
Because they're a really highly regarded firm.
So it's really important to you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's simple, isn't it? You need a wife.
Great.
I'm yours. You're just the type of man I need in my life, Jamie, and I think I'm just the type of woman for you.
Well, I really like you, and you're very attractive and helpful.
And attentive and committed. Just the type of wife you need. So let's get married.
Are you serious?
Are you?
Well, sure, I'd love to marry you.
Great.
You shouldn't have told them, Pete.
Well, they were gonna shoot my dog.
They wouldn't have shot the dog, you moron. They might have shot us, but not the dog.
Yes, they said. Sam, are you with me?
Thank you.
And there'll be more from E Street at the same time tomorrow. Coming up next, more general knowledge quickfire questions in Blockbusters.